Right, good news for parents, bad news for kids. School is back in session. Bigger needs to go. Neil Patrick Harris just sent his little ones back to the classroom, and he sat down with our own Tim Stenovic to talk about that and how he's helping teachers this fall and so much more.
And check it out.
Great to have you back here on
Cheddar.
So your own kids, they just went back to school, and this year you're doing something different. You're partnering with Quaker Chewy and AdoptAClassroom.org, the goal to raise $250,000 for schools in need. Take us through why this was a good fit for you and how the partnership came together.
We like Quaker Chewy bars, our family. We eat them normally in our day-to-day. So they approached me to partner with them for this cool initiative. Simultaneously, our kids just started school, so they're entering the third grade. And the third grade's a pretty pivotal year, right? And it's not learning to read, it's having learned to read. And so now it's a larger part of that. Math is now not just simple stuff, but more complex stuff. So I'm much more conscious and aware of teachers and what they're having to do and how they're less just hanging out with kids and making sure they don't throat punch each other, and more like actually teaching their brains to expand. And so this initiative I thought was really smart. You go buy a box of Chewy, Quaker Chewy bars, right? Go to a website, choosechewy.com. You enter the UPC code that's on the box, and Quaker will give $1 to adoptaclassroom.org, which is an amazing organization. And they'll do that all through the month of September, up to $250,000. And all of that money goes to teachers in need. Not sad teachers who need approval, but teachers who need things like school supplies and things for their classroom.
Right, teachers all over the country, they end up spending their own money on these school supplies.
This is what surprised me, because, I didn't realize what, they said 96% of all teachers end up out of pocket by over $700 a year buying things like tissue paper and construction paper. And that just seems so backwards, given the salary conversation, which is its own whole thing of making no sense, right? I feel like teachers should be much higher paid. At least this gives us an opportunity to take a little bit of onus. We eat Chewy bars anyway, and so all you have to do is go like an escape room and type in a thing and then punch in some numbers, and then all this money goes to teachers. That seems like a simple thing.
Well, you mentioned your kids going into third grade right now. They're starting third grade. Are they excited about school? How do you get them out the door in the morning? What's the secret?
They've been super excited. I don't know. I'm such a geeky nerd enthusiast about their education in front of them and learning. They hem and haw about, math packs. Oh, I gotta do 2 pages of my math pack. I am so excited. I just can't even tell you. I love the homework. I love them explaining to me how things are done. So I like that they're learning, and I hope my enthusiasm passes on to them. And also, I don't know about you, but I'm all about experiential education.
Right.
So we're teaching them, we travel together. I like going to places, real world locations, and learning stuff. So learning as a concept is something that we've done all the
time. Well, you guys are certainly experiential when it comes to Halloween, which is right around the corner. Your household is legendary for Halloween. In the past,
there
have been Star Wars themes, Batman themes, Peter Pan themes.
Yeah.
What is it going to be this year?
Last year we did the Haunted Mansion from Disney.
That was a good one.
And I'm so happy that the kids agreed to it, because that's my favorite ride. I have a Haunted Mansion obsession. This year, we're undecided, and I don't say that to avoid the question, but again, our kids are getting older, which means they're getting weirdly smarter, and they have opinions, which I hate.
Do you think they're going to, at some point, say, no, Dad, we're not doing this?
They better not.
You're going to make them do it.
They better not. I have a taser.
Okay, shifting gears. you've hosted the Tonys, you've hosted the Emmys, you've hosted the Oscars.
Yeah.
All to overwhelmingly positive reviews, but well, let's say somewhat positive reviews.
Mixed to positive.
Very positive from my household.
Brilliant.
Okay, suddenly though, these award shows, they're bypassing hosts altogether. What do you make of this development?
It's shocking.
Is it?
No, I don't. I think award shows by design are meant for water cooler chatter. If there is a host, they are the big target of a lot of ire, regardless of how it goes. If the show runs super long, then everyone thinks that the host is responsible for it. If the show doesn't have enough humor, then it's boring. If the show has too much humor, then it's not the platform to be political. It's really a challenging one, the whole conceit. Having no host is fine. It probably makes you get to spend more time getting to know the people involved in the shows, and I think that's kind of why I like to watch it. As much as you like the funny people tripping upstairs and dresses that you hate, it's kind of fun to learn about directors and editors and how that process works. Well, so I hope that there's a lot more of that and that it doesn't just seem super droll.
Well, the 2019 Emmy Awards shaping up to be among the most inclusive yet, at least for the LGBT community. Nice. Several queer actors at this point.
I'm nominated.
And yeah, filmmakers nominated. We're going to get to that.
Okay, I'm excited. I'm glad we're talking about it.
I'm curious, though, how representation on the screen has changed for LGBTQ people throughout your career. And have we come far enough? Where else is there to go?
Well, far enough is such a subjective term. We've come far enough for a lot of people and we haven't come nearly far enough for others. So I'm not one to comment on that. But there's certainly a lot more representation when you look at people who are being hired, when you look at shows even in the trans community. A show like Pose is crushing it. Not only in representation, but in storylines and in acknowledgement, and we have a lot of options now. We're a binging society with our content. We don't have to watch on a Tuesday night at 8:30 through commercials. You can choose and be very bespoke about what it is you want, and because of that, lots of Quibis and different channels are coming up with unique content that's tailor-made for certain people.
Right, there's almost a new service.
Yeah, and the representation there is really strong. So I'm just happy that we're getting as much exposure as we are, and I'm thrilled for the people who are pushing the boundaries.
All right, we're going to have more of Tim's interview with Neil Patrick Harris later on in the show. And yes, he addresses the mustache.
Thank goodness, because that was the first thing all of us saw when we first saw Neil Patrick Harris. We're like, nice stash.
Exactly.